Hi there, my name is Vishnu Mohan. I'm a data analytics student at National College of Ireland. I will be presenting my data visualization project, which is about visualizing the obesity problem in the United States of America. After a fair bit of research, I found that there is a real obesity problem in the United States. The core intention of this project is to better understand the situation. The project is performed on a dataset acquired from the open source database directory of the government of the United States of America, called data.gov. This dataset is maintained regularly by the Behavior and Risk Factor Surveillance System of the federal government of US. This is the dataset. It comes in a comma separated file. The dataset contains exactly 33 unique attributes and also has around 35,000 entries. The data contains quite a lot of null values and also garbage values, but these were cleared out using the filters which are found in Microsoft Excel, the tool of choice for this project. In order to avoid confusion and any bit of saturation, only those attributes which are considered significant are used in the project. In order to test their significance, a couple of statistical analyses are used. First, Pearson's correlation test is conducted to calculate the correlation coefficients. The test is conducted against percentage of obese population and all the other attributes which are found to be interesting. Out of the six chosen attributes, two showed very high correlation, whereas two others showed moderate correlation and two did not show significant correlation. The income and education attributes showed negative correlation. After the correlation test, a regression was conducted against the same independent and dependent variables. The results acquired were quite similar to that found in the correlation test. Finally, we move on to the visualization part. Tableau is used to conduct all data visualizations on the clean dataset. Now, let's look at my cases. Which states in the USA has the most obese and overweight adults? This question is easily answered with the help of a map plot. By adjusting the intensity of color used, we are able to effectively convey the idea. Those states represented in the darker shade contain the higher percentage of obese people. Here, Mississippi has the highest percentage of people suffering from obesity, whereas Colorado showed some of the least numbers. Although minute variations in scores of different states cannot be easily distinguished without looking closely at the numerical values, the general idea is immediately evident. And associating obesity to states would make people better engage with the data and compare lifestyle variations among these states. The question of what share of state-wise population regularly engages in leisure and muscle-strengthening physical activities is answered with the help of a map plot quite similar to the first one. Here, a green color is used to symbolize a positive aspect, whereas red color was used in the previous one to show a negative aspect. The idea here is that a lack of color intensity shows a lack of physical activity within these states. Mississippi landed in the bottom, whereas California and Oregon came out in the top. In the next question, we look at obesity amongst men and women throughout the years. It is very evident that men have a higher obesity problem than women. However, after close examination, we find that the trend amongst men is declining, whereas in the case of women, obesity problem is increasing. In order to find out why this is so, we ask the question, which gender and age categories are more prone to regular physical activity for leisure and muscular development? The result of this question is depicted with the help of a tree map. It shows that physical activity amongst people decreases as they age. It also clearly shows that men are more likely to take part in physical activities than women. This could explain why there is a growing trend of obesity within female population, but a decline in the male population. Next, we look at the role played by ethnicity and age in obesity. We see that chances for obesity increases with age, except in the most oldest category. This could be due to the high mortality rate within this demographic. When we compare different ethnicities, Hispanics, non-Hispanic blacks, and Native Americans had the highest risk for obesity, whereas Asians showed significantly less risk. From this question, it is clear that income and education attributes are inversely proportional to having an unbalanced diet. People with higher educational qualifications and those who earn more tend to choose a balanced diet. In order to summarize all the findings, we ask the question, can socioeconomic conditions be considered as an appropriate indicator of obesity? The horizontal bar chart plotted shows a very interesting scenario. Men without a high school degree and earning less than $15,000 a year has the highest risk of becoming obese, whereas college graduate women who earn more than $75,000 has the least risk of suffering from obesity. A dashboard is created in order to access all the earlier mentioned visualizations at once, and filters within Tableau are used to provide interactivity within the dashboard. By clicking on different topics, we can switch from obesity to physical activity or diet. By clicking on specific states within the map plot, we filter down all other visualizations into only the data from that specific state. This makes targeted visualization quite convenient. We can thus conclude that the right use of these influencing factors can lead to the eradication of obesity or at least help in controlling it to a certain extent. Finally, I'd like to thank you for listening to my presentation.